Ciao guys, and welcome back to Lampies. I have been not really active on the channel, I'm sorry, I've been so busy with my work, but finally I have time to do a video together.
Yes, super excited that Nina, because you're joining me, and I said that your time now is very precious, so when Alan joins me and has 20 minutes to film a video with me, I'm super, super excited. Thank you. So,
the baby choose the name.
Kind, and you see the reaction. If you go with one and you like Simon, and the baby
and start crying,
yeah, they probably don't want to give it.
Okay.
Yeah. So we have five, and yeah, I always prefer to go with unisex name. I don't know why, but I just like them, and this are kind of meaningful. So name number one is
Oshibambo name, huh?
Yes, Oshibambo name. B.
Billy.
No, Billy. M.
Billy.
M B I L I.
It's like a Billy with M.
Yes, and this.
Billy.
This means peace.
Peace.
Yes.
Billy.
So you can say Billy too, like our peace.
Mm-hmm.
I find this really beautiful.
It's nice, actually.
And it's very meaningful.
Billy. Yeah, it's nice.
Billy too.
In Billy too.
Billy is like when you say Katinaja and when you say Naja.
Oh, okay. So the full name is?
Billyetu.
Billyetu.
Yes, because on Billy, which
yes.
is where the name, the stem of the name comes from,
mm-hmm.
is peace.
Okay.
Yetu is ours. So the complete name means
it's
our
peace. That's really meaningful. It's nice. I like it.
And when you call the child every single day, you don't say Billyetu. Maybe some parents refer to do that, or grandmothers.
Mm-hmm.
But otherwise, at school, everybody else just say Billy.
Okay, and that is a unisex name, so you can give this name to
yes.
a male or a female. It doesn't matter.
I don't know if I know a male who's called Billy. But I think it's unisex.
Unisex.
It's unisex, so this sort of thing. Anyway, we are expecting a baby girl. So, but yeah, Billy. So this is... What do you think?
I love it. I mean,
the meaning is
everything. I like it a lot.
Okay, great stage. I have, now this is a little bit controversial,
mm-hmm.
because our car has the same name. So,
yeah.
So.
Okay, that I know.
Number two is Tangi. I think we have also shared it in the previous video that we did
like,
before where
mm-hmm.
we shared all the international different names.
Mm-hmm.
Tangi. And Tangi means...
Thank you. Grazie mille.
Thank you. Grazie. And that is unisex. And that's also short. It's no longer version of me.
Yeah.
It's just like Tangi.
It's just Tangi. That is also really nice. I love it because it's short. It's also meaningful.
Tangi.
Grazie.
Tangi.
It's like, thank
Tangi.
You. It's nice.
Thank you. Good. So, T-A-N-G-I. Tangi.
Mm-hmm.
Grazie. Thank you.
Thank you. I like it.
Super easy. And I feel like when you send your child to kindergarten, writing the name is... Dan, I'm
nice
out.
Also going to be good with my surname because it's TT.
Ah, okay. Yes. Also, Ali also loves this a lot because it's like T. why is why TT is nice?
I just like it. Sounds good.
Okay, so TT. So great. So Tangi, simple, easy, meaningful, unisex.
Okay. What do you have next?
I'm just hoping that when the baby comes and we say Tang is not crying because then...
Oh, yeah, also the first one.
Billy.
Billyetu. Mm-hmm. Billyetu.
Tala is a very beautiful name because it's a... is a, the short version is always Tala,
mm-hmm.
which just means to look at something.
Oh, okay.
But the names are... Now the end of these names are kind of different. You can either say Talohole, which means...
Ah, look at love. Look at love.
Or you can say Talombili, which means look at peace.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what other talas are, but they are like different versions.
And also this name is both...
Unisex.
Unisex.
Because a girl can be a tala, a guy can also be tala.
Mm-hmm. Look at.
Look at. But look, that's how you call the person, tala,
mm-hmm.
on an everyday basis.
And we have a friend of ours that is Tala.
Yes.
Talohole.
Talohole. And Ale love this.
I love this name.
I don't love it too. think it's nice. Yeah. It's also easy to cook. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm still the Italian.
And you can also just decide for the short version, like, only tala or opore.
What do you mean?
Since tala ore is so long, you can also just call the child tala
what?
Or opore.
Yes. Oh, opore is, it's a...
Too cheesy.
Name. No, it's another name, but it's quite rare in very modern. I think most people will always only say tala.
Mm-hmm.
Tala, 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 tala. And I think Italians will also not find it difficult to call
no,
it
to
tala.
Pronounce.
It's
no, it's
T-A-L-A. So, super easy.
Ah, there is no H in the middle. This is more like tala, tala.
No, it's not tala. Arabic. No. Tala.
Okay, tala.
I think when the kids are in primary school and in middle school, when they're playing around with their name, like, they're probably going to say tala and add an H. I mean, have you not done it before?
No.
Why? At school, I was like, Lempi. Maybe I'm born with a... yes, I added a Y, I added an I, I added an... Ohole is a name that is also quite recent. That's some couple now, the younger couple, call their children Ohole, which literally means amore. I don't know, it's a little bit just cheesy on the name. If I have to call you amore every single day,
I call the child amore anyway. So.
Yes, so I don't know if people are going to think it's really her real name or you're just exaggerating.
Name?
Next name. Omagano.
Omagano.
Yes.
Omagano. And why is it?
This is maybe complicated.
Yeah, I think for Italian it's too complicated.
Omagano means a gift.
Because there is this sound in the middle.
That Italians don't have.
Omagano.
Yeah, and Italians don't have the sound.
So, but anyway, what is the meaning? Tell me.
Omagano. Usually the child is going to call Magano.
Mm-hmm.
But Magano means a gift.
A gift.
Yes.
Okay.
Another name that we really, really like, and I think that you also like, Iyalo.
Ah, Iyalo, yeah, that is nice.
Iyalo is pretty much the same as Tangi, it's just another way to say thank you, Iyalo.
Yeah, thank you, yes. I remember your granny sing the song, Iyalo, Iyalo.
It's like at the wedding all the time. Iyalo, it's just like, we are thankful.
Yeah.
Iyalo is also very nice.
It
is. It's to call Iyalo.
Yellow. Do you have anybody in your family that is called Yellow?
Yes, I do have a cousin. Yellow.
And your cousin.
Yellow. But the writing is a little bit.
But usually in your culture, it's really strong. These things of having a namesake, like you have somebody that you know, a close friend, and you give.
Yes, that
name
is
for
true.
Your close friend, isn't it?
Yes. Because for us, a name is also you're passing on the character of that person
to the child. Ooh, that is really important.
Exactly. So very last name, which I have here, unisex, very, very nice, is Tuli.
Tuli, another T. So we stay with TT.
Yes.
Because T in your culture is always there.
Yes. I know, initially, I was always thinking of tuna, but...
Tuna, no.
But tuna was going
tuna.
To be...
And what is the meaning of tuna?
Tuna means like we have got something. It's again like it's a stem of the name. So you say tuna and then you can now say tunombili, we have got peace.
Ah, okay.
You can then say tunokole, we have got love. You can say... Yes, you can say tunonkwathi, we have got a helper, but I think that's too much pressure on a child.
Yeah. Are you disabled? You name your child.
No, because in my culture they say once you give birth, you are relieved from your duty. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you just sit under the barua tree and you say, please bring, in this case. So that's why, the helper, we have, just sit, you don't have to move anymore. So, yeah.
Tuna, no, because...
Tuna is no, because
also, yeah,
tuna salad, and if you like...
And kids, the kindergarten can be cruel, so you cannot...
Primary school also.
Primary school, you can't.
Tuna, have you got tuna salad?
I have tuna salad, tuna.
Yeah, so Ali said this
no,
no, no.
That is
also in Italy, so I'm going to find it a little bit maybe cheesy.
No, it's not cheesy, it's about crazy.
So I thought Tuli.
Tuli.
Yes. Now Tuli is almost to say
Tuli. It sounds nice. It's really feminine in my opinion.
Yeah, it's also unisex.
Mm-hmm.
And you can say like Tuli.
Tuli
mobili. Yeah?
Tulipans. The flower.
No. You can say whatever. Tuli. It's just to, you can say Tuli mobili. Maybe we are in peace.
Mm-hmm.
But you can also just give. I would just give it Tuli as it is.
Okay.
And then we have still TT.
Mm-hmm. Tuli is also nice. Any TT.
And again, it's short. When you're teaching the child how to write their own names, right? T-U-L-I. Tuli.
Yes.
Tuli.
I like like short names more than long ones.
So Tuli, you are in.
Mm-hmm.
Yellow.
Yellow, I mean.
Tangi.
Tala or Talohole, I mean.
Talohole, you're in. Billy?
Billy, also, I really love the meaning, but the full version of it, I think it's going to be a little bit complicated.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when
there you have it. 5 Bumble name unisex. Let us know in the comment which one do you prefer, which one you like. We are going to decide probably.
Oh, which one do you think the baby is going to react to positively?
Oh, you don't know, it depends on the baby, it depends on the audience.
That's
huh?
True, but okay. Yeah.
Good, then that was it for today, guys. Leave us a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and see you soon. Ciao, ciao, ciao.
Yeah, but also before we... Oh.
Wait, I was already going to turn off the camera.
Before we go, I would also just want to wish you all like a beautiful Easter time with your family.
Yes,
it's Easter.
Right.
I don't even know if you know that it's Easter because you woke up waking today in the morning.
Yeah.
Probably you still think it's a normal waking day. But yeah, hope you guys are doing well. We are, I don't know, now I feel like celebration for us is always just the two of us.
Yeah. My
so
goodness.
Sometimes it feels a little
weird. But we have a big plan. I'm going to prepare all sort of Italian speciality for Austin, for Easter, and then we are going to have probably lamb with potatoes. We are going to have a cheesecake, but it's not like the cheesecake that you think, it's not sweet, it's like a parmigiano cake, so it's savory, it's really nice, I love it, and also some other things. So
if you don't need,
and we have also tripa, try it, matangara. We have matangara,
nothing to do with the
it's also like a play traditional from my region. There's a tripe, is really traditional. Do you remember when?
Yeah, but for Easter.
Yes, also for Easter.
Oh, okay. I was going to make a brioche. I have to see how I'm feeling tomorrow.
Okay.
Because these days, I'm like, my energy level is like,
Don't you worry. I have free time, I can cook.
A brioche. Can you make a brioche?
I can make everything. Maybe I'm Italian.
Yeah, I trust you. I'm cooking everything great.
Bye. Ciao.